Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Leeann, and in today's video, I'm going to show you all the stuff that I picked up from Primark, and only one thing that I picked up from Urban Outfitters while I'm still here in Germany. So I bought quite a few things from Primark. I went to Dusseldorf with my boyfriend, and I actually went there the last time I was here, so I was really excited to go back again. We didn't buy too many things from like one section. It's kind of like all over the place. There are, how many floors in that store? Like the basement has accessories, shoes, bags, and the main floor has women's stuff. I think the second floor has women's stuff, and then the top floor has men's clothing and children's clothing. So what I just say, like four floors. So it's a really big store. I always end up spending like 2 hours there, and I had a lot of fun there this time. I bought so many things, but let me just get the Urban Outfitters thing out of the way. The Urban Outfitters there was right next door, and I was a little bit disappointed. I haven't bought anything from Urban Outfitters in years, and I always bought stuff from there. But I think I'm just not really into the fashion these days, so I just completely went past the clothing and I went upstairs to the accessories place, or what do you call it, like home place, home section. And all I did was pick up one thing from them, and this is the A6 Lightbox Marble. It includes 92 letters, numbers, and symbols. So this is an LED little like letter box thing, and I've been wanting one of these for so long. They had them on their site. I think they still have them, have this one and their other letter board that isn't an LED box on their site. And I looked stuff up on Amazon, and same deal, like they're just really expensive, so I didn't even bother picking them up. So when I saw this on clearance for 15 euros, I picked it up. And when we got to the register, it was actually on sale for 10 euros. So I definitely had to pick it up. I would have spent 15 euros on it anyway, but I'm really glad that it was 10 euros. So I'm gonna take it out of the package for you. So this is what the box looks like. It's really small, and it comes with these letters, and it actually has emojis. It's really cute. They are all clear. I didn't check to see if it works or not because I do have batteries, but I don't have a screwdriver here at my Airbnb because you have to screw these out, unscrew these, I mean, and then put the batteries in here. So I didn't even bother with that yet. And I didn't want to break these apart yet just to show you first. So here are all the letters and the emojis. Super cute. I'm gonna try the box right now. I think just for now, I'm just gonna put an at sign. I'm gonna put my handle in here at Tea with Lee, by the way. You should follow me on all my social media platforms. Actually, I think it's gonna be up here, but I only pretty much use Instagram mainly and Pinterest sometimes. But I love using Pinterest. It gives me a lot of inspiration for 20 years later when I can own my own house. Look at that, isn't that cute? The at sign. Hopefully, when I figure out when I'm gonna get a screwdriver, this will light up and look pretty good. I don't really mind if it doesn't light up, but I did pay extra for something that lights up, so hopefully that'll look really nice. Okay, I have my little sign set up here. I don't know if you can read it, but I have that in my backgrounds in my future videos when I go back home. So from Primark, I'm just gonna take things randomly out of the bag because they're all over the place. But first I got a 5 wooden hanger set here. It says polished finish on it. It's very polished. Ow, my hair got caught. And we like these hangers from Primark. They're $2.50, and we like the ones at IKEA, but that IKEA is pretty difficult to get to because it's pretty much like off the highway. We don't have a car, and I don't think the train station, what? Train station takes you there? So we just, we went to Primark and found that they have pretty good hangers. So we bought another set. He needs those for his clothes. He also wanted this beach towel that's in the pattern of the German flag. It's actually a very nice towel. We have two more beach towels from there. And I mentioned this in my last Primark haul, that we're not planning on going to the beach, like, you know, with these towels or anything. It's just we prefer to use beach towels for our like shower towels, because they're much bigger and longer. So when we come out of the shower, we're not freezing our butts off. We can just like drape it over ourselves and be warm with that. From the home section again, but at Primark, I got an LED love light, and it's in rose gold. This was 6 euros. I forgot how much the beach towel is. It's 10 euros. But the love light, I really wanted this again for like my background at home. I feel like it's so cute. I don't think they have other ones. I think I only saw this one, but they do have some like really cute like ice cream cone LED lights. It's like this tiny little thing here, but I just decided to get this one also because I guess ice cream and I were not really like, I don't know. If they had something else than an ice cream cone, I probably would have picked that up, but I'm just gonna have this at the in my background somewhere in my future videos. I haven't tried that out, obviously, so I will let you know in the future. Oh, if you see it in my background, if it works or not. I bought a pair of these slides or slippers, whatever they call them now, and I wanted these for my vacation trip thing to Disney World soon, because my mom was telling me that back then when we went on vacation as a family, my brother and I would always be sleeping in, of course, and then my parents would wake up early. So while my brother and I were getting ready to leave, my mom would just slip on a pair of whatever sandals she had and go downstairs, bring up some breakfast for us, and then we'd leave. So I wanted a pair for myself. I have slippers, which I use to walk around the hotel room, but I don't want to do it like walk around the whole hotel in them. So I just picked these up. They're actually really cute and very comfortable. They have a ton of slippers, but I figured these would, I don't know, match anything. And I can actually wear this with outfits. This is a really nice pair of suede. For him, we got a set of cotton stretch hipsters for 8 euros. He just needed more underwear. And they're really nice underwear. It's like a whole wall full of them. We got a set of 5 invisible socks with non-slip grip. I have pretty big feet. I wear a size 7 and he wears a size 8 in men's, and I feel like my feet are pretty much like almost the same size as his, so he wanted to get this for me, but I just wanted him to have it, so in case I need this, because I actually have been wearing my canvas sneakers by Keds, my all white Keds, and they've actually been hurting my feet a little bit, especially since I forgot my flats socks at home. So I have been going barefoot in my sneakers, and I hate that so much. And especially because I don't know what happened, but my Keds are actually hurting my feet now. They give me like a little bit of blisters. I have very wide feet. So we picked this up, and now that I showed this to you in a video, I can finally wear them. Oh, we picked up another 3 set of stretch hipsters. This is seam-free. Very nice underwear. It's really soft. And then I picked up from their beauty section. This is the only thing I picked up from their beauty section, because I don't know, I feel kind of like, I feel too overwhelmed when I go into like clothing stores and they have a beauty section like Forever 21 and H&M. I just don't shop in those areas because there are a lot of things that have been opened or, you know, tampered with. And there were no testers at Primark, so I was just thinking like, why is everybody opening up these packages and touching everything? There were products that I was really interested in. So there were eyeshadow palettes, some liquid lipsticks, and you know, all that, but I just couldn't bring myself to pick anything up. It's not really that I think they're cheap products, because I do think they're pretty cheap, as in like cheap quality, but I did swatch only one eyeshadow in a palette that I was interested in, and it was pretty pigmented, but I think I was just really turned off by the fact that everything was open, that I just didn't pick anything up. Anyway, so I just stuck to the skincare section, and I really like their skincare section. I have a lot of like really cute things, like my strawberry cooling eye patches that I showed in my last haul. Those are so cute and I still use them all the time. But I just decided to pick up the natural exfoliating mitt. And this is, they say you can use it on your face, but I would never use these on my face. But I wanted to use this for my back, and especially because it's like a mitten, so it might give me a little bit more control if I use it for my, like, by myself, I mean, because it's really hard for me to get back there. But hopefully this works. If it does, and I need two more, like I need another one for the other hand, I might go back and get another one. You never know. In the accessories section, I picked up this purse. Now, I don't mean to sound like, I don't know, arrogant, I guess, but I pretty much only carry designer handbags. And I'm sure a lot of women out there, not just YouTubers, carry designer handbags only. I just happen to be one of those, but I decided to pick up an affordable handbag because I don't like to travel with any of my designer handbags when I go on trips, just because something might happen, or I don't know, you never really know. And Disney World is not really a place where you want to be walking around with like a Louis Vuitton bag or a Gucci bag, Coach bag. Also, here in Germany, it rains quite often, so I just stick to one of my other bags. It's not a designer handbag, but it's still a very expensive bag. But just in case I want to go out at night, have a really nice time, you know, complete my nice outfit, instead of carrying one of my, well, that main purse handbag thing that isn't, it's not a dressy, it's not a dressy handbag, I thought I might as well just pick something up. And I actually was looking at a blush colored one because, you know, that's like the color that's in right now for the spring. But the strap was so thick that it just completely made the handbag look kind of stupid. It's pretty much like the same size as this bag, and it just imagine having like really thick straps. It was really stupid looking. I would have gotten it if the straps weren't ugly like that. So my boyfriend actually pointed this one out, and at first I was kind of like, I don't really know if I like the chains on it. I mean, this is like a really nice, like dainty looking, sophisticated bag. I don't know about the chains, but I actually like put this on and I looked at myself and I was like, oh my god, that actually looks really nice. And it totally matched my outfit that I was wearing that day. I was wearing this outfit, probably really bad, but it's like a floral blouse, pink pants, and my Keds. And I had this bag on in the mirror and it completed my outfit and I was sold. So this is not a blush color, it's more like a taupe color, but it's really nice. I love that it does have chains. I am not opposed to chains. I really love chains on bags, but I just thought, like, you know, with the imbalance, but it actually does balance out pretty nicely. I love this hardware here. It's a pretty roomy bag actually, but it doesn't hold too much stuff, which is good because I tend to like pile in a lot of stuff in my bags. This pretty much only fits my big makeup bag, which I guess is enough for me. Unfortunately, there is no like zipper pocket for like wallets and phones and stuff, but this pocket is okay. I love that it has the ability to turn into a messenger bag, so I can have it like shorter, so I can do it over the shoulder, or I can just do it on one shoulder, so it's really nice. And I think this was only 12 euros or something like that. I don't remember, 10, 11. So Primark has really good prices. You obviously have to make sure that you pick things that are not like super cheap, you know what I'm saying? I think lastly from the accessory section, I got this 3 set of earrings for 2 euros. So here are the earrings. These are cute little like rhinestone studs. These are L's. They have a lot of letter jewelry, and I wanted a horoscope one too, but for some reason there were like no Sagittarius ones. And this was the only L accessory set that we could find. They had these earrings in a pendant, and they didn't have the one in L. And they also had a huge, like a huge pendant in the letter family thing, and I did not want that. It was just way too big. I'll just show you his pants, because obviously I'm not gonna do a try on haul with his pants. But he got a pair of these Denim Company skinny jeans, stretch denim. And look at that. They are really stretchy. They have a ton of jeans there, like a ton. A ton, a ton, a ton. And I was at first not really interested in their jeans when I first got there, because I have a lot of jeans and they're expensive and really nice, but we just wanted to look at their jeans this time. I did buy a pair of jeans for myself and he got a pair of jeans for himself, and they're actually pretty nice quality. These jeans were 18 euros, so I think that's kind of a steal. Like, these are very soft and they're very stretchy. They remind me a lot of his American Eagle pants jeans, and maybe even some of like the Levi's jeans that he picked up from Target. So you would be surprised when you go into Primark the things that you would find for very affordable price. So now I'm going to do my little try-on haul. I didn't buy too many things. I will show you first what I got and then I'll show them to you on me in the mirror. But these are really cute floral pants that were 13 euros and I wear a size 2. Some things I wear a size 4. I will show you what size I wear in the jeans. These are, I think, like a peach color. I know it's so funny, but this kind of is like the trend or style these days. My mom and I think my grandma would even say like, we can make these pants for you. And my grandma has made pants for me that look very much like this. I think I have a whole set that she made, but these are so cute. I love pants like this. I don't know what happened, but I just kind of not really got over wearing jeans, but I really have gotten into wearing very flowy pants like this. So I'm definitely kind of like stocking up on these and I'm not mad about that. This over the shoulder top was kind of like my last minute pick. I wasn't sure if I was going to like it or not because I don't really like the, oh, did I say over the shoulder? On the shoulder? I meant off the shoulder. I wasn't sure if I liked this because I don't really like the off the shoulder look on myself. I think when I see it on other people, like on YouTube or Instagram, I think it looks great on them, but I have very broad shoulders. I'm not like self-conscious about my body anymore really, but I just don't want to put too much emphasis on my shoulders sometimes. So I thought like this would just make my body look really disproportionate, but actually this looks pretty nice. I'm not gonna lie, this looks pretty nice. And I hate this whole like trend thing where everything has to be cropped. I'm gonna show you a cropped off the shoulder top that I got anyway, so I'm kind of like contradicting myself here. But I got that top that I just mentioned first, and then I found this one. But I had to pick this up because the print's really cute. It's a black top with white polka dots and it has butterflies all over it, so it's great for the summer and the spring. It's a full length top, like that's what I want to see. Like if I'm gonna wear one trend, it's just gonna be on one part of a top or one part of that clothing. I don't want it to be off the shoulder and cropped. And I'm kind of like, I feel like I'm too old to wear crop tops. I bought a lot in the past like three years ago. I bought a lot. I outgrew all of them. And I still feel like every time I look at crop tops in the store, I feel like that's just meant for babies. So I'm kind of like throwing out a lot of crop tops in my wardrobe. But of course, who would I be if I didn't pick up a crop top that was also off the shoulder? My boyfriend loves this, by the way. He thinks it flatters me pretty well. If I was like older, like maybe when I'm 30, I probably won't feel the same anymore. And I probably wouldn't have agreed to get it if I didn't like work out and be fit, because this thing would look like horrible on me. But this was 5 euros. It's that like accordion fabric and look to it. It's nothing on the back. It's all white and it has this floral print on it. And that was like another thing that I wasn't sure if I wanted to get it because it just looks like a top that I had when I was small. Honestly, this looks like a shirt I had when I was in elementary school. I got this because I wanted to wear something nice for Disney World in case I go out at night and have a really nice dinner. And this is my first bodysuit and it's kind of cropped at the bottom. It's kind of like bell bottom legs. It's really, really cute. I love this. I have this in a size 2. I try everything in 2 sizes. I always do size 2 and size 4 because my rib cage and my shoulders always get like, they always expand every year, but everything else is still pretty petite. So I could be a 2. I tried the 4, it was way too big. The armpits were very saggy, but I got a size 2 to try as well, and it totally fits. It comes with a cute tie in front, so it can cinch in your waist, and I love this print so much. I feel so summery. Like, it's not summery yet, but I feel like it's gonna be really nice for the summer. And then lastly, I got this pair of pants. So these are the jeans that I got. They're really stretchy. They are a mid-rise. On me, it is not mid-rise, it is high waist. And I feel like because I'm super small, like petite, that mid-rise jeans, they come up so high that they're high-waisted. So to me, they're high-waisted. This was 19 euros. I didn't know if I would like this line that goes down the front all the way here, and I didn't know if I would like the slit here because I was still thinking that the slit would be on the side, but it actually is not. It's right in the front. But when I tried it on, it was really, really nice. Nothing on the back. I got this actually in a size 6, so USA size 6. I do not wear 6 pants in anything. In any brand ever. I pretty much have reached a size 4, which to me is a milestone because I've always been petite. But I decided to go a size up in these because one, they're high-waisted on me. So wearing the size 4 jeans were, it was so tight. Let me just say it was so tight. The waist was tight, the pants, the legs were very tight. So I just want to size up and they're much easier to squeeze into, but it's a little baggier, but I feel like when I wash it and throw it in the dryer, shrink it a little bit, it might fit. And it also gives me an incentive to gain, like try to continue to gain weight so that I can fit into these jeans. It would probably take me many, many years to finally fit a size 6, but I think in this case, because it's high-waisted and going up a size, it was like a good idea. And I didn't want to not get these jeans because they're actually really, really nice. So now let's get on to the try-on part of this haul. So here is the first outfit. I have the white off-the-shoulder top. I just took off my straps and just tucked them in here. But I would definitely wear this with my stick-on bra and pair it with a pair of high-waisted shorts or actually shorts, yeah. I would totally wear those high-waisted shorts, but also high-waisted jeans, and these are the high-waisted jeans in a size 6, as I mentioned. As you can see, they're quite flattering, but not as flattering as size 4. Size 4 was, I would say, like the perfect fit in terms of the way everything just hugged my body, but it was just way too tight, and I wasn't exactly sure if it would loosen up after a wash and being in the dryer. So I just decided to go the safer route and go a size up. So you can see it wrinkles at my knees and there's a lot of looseness here at the crotch area. But the back pretty much fits really well. Of course, you can just see all the wrinkling there. So it's not the worst pair of jeans, but it just fits a little looser now. And I'm sure that when it shrinks, it'll be pretty nice. I don't really have to shrink it. I could just leave it like this. I'm totally fine with it. And there are the slits at the bottom. And here are the slides. They're actually really nice. I couldn't really see for sure what they looked like in the store just because I didn't want to take my socks off, but they look pretty nice. Here's the other pants. I love these pants so much. I love the length on them. They hit just a little past my ankle, so I don't have to tailor them or anything. They don't drag on the floor. They have pockets, which is a deal breaker when it comes to buying pants like this. And I would probably wear this top with these pants too. I don't know, maybe this might be a little bit too much because I have flowers on my pants already, but I just love the fit. It's so nice and they're very comfortable. Here's the other off-the-shoulder top. So here's the other off-the-shoulder top. It's really cute, very nice. I'd totally wear this to dinner if I wanted to. I would not wear it with these pants though. Actually, no, because it's too flowy on the top and it's too flowy on the bottom and I don't like the imbalance, but I mean, it looks really cute for like PJs, but I love this top. The only thing about these tops that will obviously be really annoying is that when you do that, it'll go up. So you have to always adjust and put them back down, but it's really, really comfortable, very flowy. I got this in a size 2. And I think I did it, I got a size 0 just to see if the straps, or what do you call these, the sleeves would be too large on this, like too loose. But that was actually very, very painful because that was really tight. So size 2 fits perfectly. Here's the last try-on piece of clothing. And this is the bodysuit. It's a little tight here because underneath the tie is actually some elastic. It's actually pretty nice. It really does cinch in the waist. Love the pockets as usual.
nothing in the back, but it's very flattering. If it was a dress and this was a slit in the front, I think it would look really sexy and really nice for a night out. Could technically wear this during the day too, but I love this for a really nice dinner, and I probably could pair it with these slides too. And the thing I love about this is that it has adjustable straps. When I first put this on, it felt a little tight in the armpit area, so I tried on a size 4 and it was very loose in the armpits, and I just thought, okay, never mind, then I'll just loosen up these straps. So these straps are actually at their loosest, so that goes to show you that I might be really petite, but I have very broad shoulders, so it's really difficult for me to find clothes that fit pretty well. But I'm actually really glad that I got this. This is my first bodysuit ever. I'm so excited to wear it. As you can see, I'm not wearing the right bra. This is actually pretty low, and my bra sits a little bit higher just because this is not an underwire bra, so I would totally wear this with my stick-on bra. If you're wondering what stick-on bra I use, I will show you in the next clip. This is my stick-on bra, and I love this so much. I already tried it and tested it out and everything, and it fits really, really well. I got this, I believe, from Macy's last year. They were having a sale, and I think if I find them again, I will definitely pick up another one. The brand is New Bra. I don't think my camera's gonna focus on that, but it's N-U-B-R-A, New Bra. Oh, it's right here, which you probably can't tell anyway. So I definitely recommend that you try this. Stick-on bras, I think they work the best with those who have very small breasts like me, so this one is definitely a favorite of mine. Before I end this video, I'm really sorry, but I didn't know I had this clothesline up here before I filmed my try-on, but Airbnb life.
So that was the end of my Primark haul. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to see more videos from me and click that notification bell so you get notified of all my future uploads. I also would recommend that you do click that notification bell because sometimes I post at different weird hours, and sometimes I postpone my videos by like a day because I am on travel. Tell me what you like to get at Primark. By the way, all of that stuff costs 137 euros. I think that's so good for all the stuff that we picked up. It was the same thing like that last time. We did go a little crazier because that was my first time there and I was like, oh, let me just pick everything up. But I really like that place. If you like this try-on haul, I'll have a video coming up very soon, if not like after this, that is a video on all the outfits that I wore during this trip to Germany. So hopefully you'll enjoy that. I hope to see you in my next video. Bye!